All right, shalom, shalom to the elect of the nation of Israel, the elect of Yahweh Shai. All praises and glory is due to Yahweh Bashem Yahshai, Bashem Rakah Kodash, for giving us this knowledge, this truth, this understanding, especially in the times we're living in. Now, speaking of the times that we're living in, which is a time of prophecy, one of the major prophecies that's left to be fulfilled besides the mandatory implantation of the you know what is the head up battle between, and when I say head up meaning America and Russia going at it head up, like they say in, you know, in the streets, we're gonna go head up, meaning America and Russia will lock horns, so to speak, which will precipitate World War III. And that is according to Bible prophecy. All right, it's not a maybe or might be, it's inevitable. And this is one of the reasons why Russia is flexing its muscle. Right now they're dealing with the Ukraine situation, but it's not gonna stop there, okay? Russia, they're gonna continually flex their muscle until they get it an idea in their head, and this is according to Bible prophecy, they get an idea in their head to come against America. Okay, and that's pursuant to Ezekiel, I believe is the 38th chapter. Now, what inspired me to go into this topic, that being Russia and America locking horns in war, so to speak, is the video that Elder Mawatazak, and this is his channel here, GMS Mawatazak Bungod. The name of the video is entitled War Update. I will go to them that are at rest, that dwell safely. And I was checking out that video yesterday, and I said, you know what, I will do a slight commentary on it. Of course, I'm not going to play the whole video, but, you know, a little portion of the video I'm going to play, and then do a commentary to it. Hopefully, it'll be edifying to you brothers and you few sisters out there that watch these videos. So, again, you see the title, I will go to them that are at rest, that dwell safely. And again, that's a quote from the Bible, all right? That's a quote from the book of Ezekiel, and that's also prophecy, because eventually Russia is going to get it into their mind to attack America. Again, this is why Russia as of late is flexing its muscle. It's getting ready. The Heavenly Father, one of the titles of the Heavenly Father is the Lord of Hosts, meaning the Lord of Armies, and he's stirring up the spirit of the so-called Russians. Again, that's Bible prophecy too. I will raise up the spirit of the Medes, roughly paraphrasing that scripture. What that means is the spirit of the so-called Russians led by Vladimir Putin is being stirred up, okay, stirred up for war. So today is the Ukraine situation. Tomorrow is going to be America, meaning in the future, you know, ultimately Russia is going to come against America. So without further ado, let's play a little bit of this video. I'm going to get into a couple of scriptures dealing with that very subject, and hopefully, like I said, this video will be edifying to you brothers and your sisters out there. This is one of the major prophecies we got to keep in mind, besides the mandatory implantation of that MOTB. One of the major prophecies we got to keep in mind is America and Russia going to war, okay, and that's going to precipitate World War III. So without further ado, let's check it out.
Alright, shalom, shalom. Before I get started, as always, I want to give all praise to Yahweh, Bahashem, Yahweh Shai, Bahashem, Rakah HaKodash. Double honors to the apostles and the elders of Great Millstone, and salutation and blessings to the hopeful members of the elect scattered throughout the four winds of the earth, alright? That believe wholeheartedly in the true doctrine being pushed, who are in hope of mercy and salvation during the time of Jacob's trouble, which is fastly approaching. as well as when Yahweh Shai returns to the planet Earth, okay? This would be a WW3 update, wars and rumors of wars type prophecy video, okay? Dealing with the coming invasion of the United States of America, okay, by Russia and China. Okay, now the scriptures speak about this, and we're going to definitely pull these scriptures, all right, because this is the time of Great Babylon's fall. This is the time Yahweh Shai spoke about, all
right? Right. This is the time of Great Babylon's fall, meaning America. And according to Bible prophecy, the Lord is going to use Russia to destroy this place called America. Okay, if we go in the book of... Ezekiel, I know it's in there, to prove that. Again, this is the book of Ezekiel, the 38th chapter. And let's start at the 14th verse. It says, "Therefore, son of man, prophesy and say unto Gog, thus saith the Lord power, in that day..." Now, it says, "son of man, prophesy." Who's that talking about? That's talking about the Lord's prophets, such as we are. And we believe that according to faith. So we are, part of our prophecy is to speak about this, to speak about Gog, which represents Russia today. Russia is known as Gog today, is to speak about the impending nuclear war between Russia and America, because it's Bible prophecy. So the Lord told us to do this. He said, "Therefore, son of man, prophesy and say unto Gog, thus saith the Lord power," see, "in that day when my people of Israel dwelleth safely, shall thou not know it? And thou shalt come from thy place out of the north parts, thou and many people with thee." One of the countries that's going to come with Russia to attack America is China. That's why you just heard Muwatazak mention Russia and China. Now, when you go in the Apocrypha, it speaks about Asia. Thou, to roughly paraphrase that scripture, it says, "Thou art a wretch. Thou art partaker of the hope of Babylon." So it's talking about China. Okay, China is, outside of Russia, China is the next superpower that is, for lack of a better word, vying for control. Okay, China, right? So it says, "Thou shalt come from thy north, from thy place out of the north parts, thou and many people with thee, all of them riding upon horses, a great company and a mighty army." The so-called Chinese alone have a mighty army. Okay, I'm not sure of the number of soldiers that they have. I think it's, if I'm not mistaken, I think it's 1 billion, if I'm not mistaken. Now, if I am mistaken, you can correct me in the comment section. But they have a very, very, very large army, so-called Chinese, okay? And they pride themselves in that too. So this is what is meant by a great company and a mighty army. Let's keep reading. It says, "And thou shalt come up against my people of Israel as a cloud to cover the land. It shall be in the latter days." What time period are we in, people? We're in the latter days of this man's kingdom. Okay, so another prophecy to look forward to is Russia attacking Israel, because Israel is a problem state, because indeed it is a state, all right? It's not the nation of Israel, it's the state of Israel. And that came about on May 14th, 1948, when Israel became a state. The prime minister at that time was David Ben-Gurion, and he announced the state of Israel. Now, since that was created, that's been a major problem in the Middle East, a hotbed for war, if you will. And one of the countries that can't stand Israel is Russia. Okay, among you have other countries like Libya. You know the so-called Arabs can't stand that tiny state of Israel. So, reading on, it says, "And thou shalt come against my people of Israel as a cloud to cover the land. It shall be in the latter days, and I will bring thee against my land," that's the land of Israel, "that the heathen may know me, when I shall be sanctified in thee, O Gog, before their eyes." See? So the Lord is going to use Israel to help fan those flames of war. Now, if Israel and America get into warfare, I'm sorry, if Israel and Russia, that's what I meant to say, get into warfare, then you know America will join in, because America is a god to Israel. All right? America is a god to the state of Israel. So if Russia attacks Israel, then automatically America is going to jump in. America is going to get in. All right? And that's exactly what the Heavenly Father Yahweh wants. That is his will. That is his plan. Again, this is why he has the title, the Lord of Hosts. There's a scripture where it says, "The Lord of Hosts mustereth the hosts of the battle." So that's what's going on right now, man. Okay? And notice what the Lord said here. He said, "When I shall be sanctified in thee, O Gog, before their eyes." Now, back in the past, when someone wanted to be sanctified, they would offer up a sacrifice. Guess what? The Lord said he has a sacrifice in Bozrah. Let's read that. A sacrifice. And when you go into the word sacrifice, it means make. It literally means make holy. Sacri means holy in the Latin / Italian. Fice or facere means to do. So when you put the word together, it means to make holy. That's what a sacrifice does. It purifies. So here, when we read in Isaiah 34. You know what? I'm going to have to start at the first verse. Isaiah 34 and 1. "Come near, ye nations, to hear, and hearken, ye people. Let the earth hear, and all that is therein, the world and all things that come from it. For the indignation of the Lord is upon all nations." The anger of the Lord is upon all nations. And he's going to make them fight each other. Okay? "And his fury upon all their armies. He have utterly destroyed them. He have delivered them to the slaughter." And what's going to do that? What's going to bring that slaughter? Those missiles, man. Those nuclear missiles. That's number one. And number two, those chariots. Okay? Anyway, let's keep reading. It says, "Their slain also shall be cast out," a lot of dead bodies, "and their stink shall come up out of their carcasses." Now, when you go back to Ezekiel, one of the things that the top wicked elite, because they're going to survive this nuclear war, this war, if you will, because they have their bomb shelters and their outer space retreats, and that's pursuant to Amos, the 9th chapter. So they're going to survive. Also, it's pursuant to Psalms, the 149th chapter. They have to survive so that prophecy could be fulfilled, where they're going to be chained up, right? One of their first jobs, you know, is going to be marking bodies and burying bodies. You're going to have a group that's going to go around and mark where the dead bodies are, and then you're going to have another group come behind them and bury those bodies. All right, and that's going to be the other nation, starting with the nation of Esau, Edom, starting with the top elites. That's going to be their first job. You know, there's roughly paraphrasing the scripture where it says, "They shall seek out men of continual employment." That's talking about us when we come back into power. Employment means slavery. It's another word for slavery. So those top banking families that's going to survive the nuclear destruction, they're going to go right into slavery. And one of their first jobs is going to be identifying the dead bodies and burying them. And that's pursuant to Ezekiel, the book of Ezekiel. I believe it's the 39th chapter. So this is a great future coming, man. Anyway, let's get back to Isaiah 34 and 3. Their slain also shall be cast out. So you're going to have a lot of dead bodies, and we're not going to bury them. And guess what? If the dead bodies don't get buried, that brings diseases. So the dead bodies left from those wars are going to have to be buried. We're not going to be the ones doing it. Our slaves are going to do it, beginning with Esau, Edom, beginning with the top banking families. They're the ones that's going to do it. And Ezekiel, the 39th chapter, goes into it. Their slain also shall be cast out, and their stink shall come up out of their carcasses, and the mountain shall be melted with their blood. And all the host of heaven shall be dissolved, and the heavens shall be rolled together as a scroll. That's talking about the nuclear cloud, mushroom cloud, if you will. And all their hosts shall fall down. That's from the nuclear radiation, all right? The when the bombs go off. As the leaf falleth off from the vine, as a fallen fig from the fig tree. For my sword shall be bathed in heaven. Again, those are the nuclear missiles. Behold, it shall come down upon Idumea. That's a Greek way of saying Edom, Esau. And upon the people of my cursed judgment. So that's part of the Lord's judgment. Now here's the point. It says, the sword of the Lord is filled with blood. It is made fat with fatness, with the blood of lambs and goats. Now that's a metaphor for the people. The people are like these lambs and goats, okay? And those missiles, along with the chariots of the Lord, they're going to kill a lot of people, man. A lot of people are going to die on that day, all right? It's going to be a river or rivers of blood, should I say, with the blood of lambs and goats, with the fat of the kidneys of rams. These are all dark sayings for people, okay? This is a dark saying for people. Now here's the point. For the Lord have a sacrifice in Bozrah. Now, back in Ezekiel 38 and 16, the Lord says, hey, I shall be sanctified in thee, O Gog. You go back to Isaiah 34, the Lord says he has a what? A sacrifice in Bozrah. Now, Bozrah was a capital city in the land of Edom. So the modern day Bozrah would be America. America is this capital city of the Edomites. This is the place where they make their most money, America. This is their shining crown of glory, if you will, their cash cow, if you will. So America would represent the modern day Bozrah. So here the Lord says he has a sacrifice in Bozrah. Going back to Ezekiel 38, he said he shall be sanctified in thee, O God. I mean, he's going to use the Russians to come against America. Okay, to shoot missiles on it, along with China and the other nations that's going to be coming with Russia. They're going to get it on with America. And missiles are going to be shot. And that's the sacrifice that the Lord is talking about. The Lord says he has a sacrifice in Bozrah. Again, he also said he shall be sanctified in thee, O God. You see the connection? Do you see the connection? All right. Sanctified, sacrifice, basically means the same thing. Okay. So this is a major prophecy, man. For the Lord have us. And by the way, I'm reading this in the Old Testament, Isaiah 34. This prophecy has not been fulfilled yet. We're still waiting for this prophecy to be fulfilled. For the Lord have a sacrifice in Bozrah and a great slaughter in the land of Idumea. There you go. A great slaughter, and that's talking about here, right here in America. A great slaughter. As a matter of fact, all of America is going to be on fire from those missiles in the chariots. That's the Lord's sacrifice. All right? 5,000 square miles of nothing but red, hot, roaring fire. Hence the title, The Lake of Fire. America is going to be turned into a lake of fire. And that's how the Lord is going to sanctify himself. Like he said, I shall be sanctified in thee, O God. See? So, hey, let's jump down to the 8th verse. For it is the day of the Lord's vengeance, see? And the year of the recompenses for the controversy of Zion. Yeah, the Lord's vengeance for what the nation of Edom did to his chosen people, the Israelites. You know, beginning with slavery and all the wickedness that the Edomites did in the past and have been doing to the Lord's people, the Israelites. All right, because we've been crying unto the Lord to bring that revenge, to bring that judgment. Just like when we were in Egypt, you had the Israelites crying against the Egyptians to the Lord to bring the Egyptians down, to bring that judgment upon the Egyptians for their hard bondage. It's the same thing now, okay? It's the same thing now. So there you go. So let's get back to the video.
This is the time where Yahushua said, these be the days of vengeance in Luke, the 21st chapter. I believe it's verse 19, if I'm not mistaken. But these be the days of vengeance, all right, when all things shall be fulfilled. Okay, we're at the end. Not only do we have this war.
When all things shall be fulfilled, and one of the things that must be fulfilled is Russia coming against America, thinking that evil thought to go against America. Let's read it. And then I have an article I want to show you, which backs that up as well. It is right here, the book of Ezekiel 38:10. Thus saith the Lord power, it shall also come to pass that at the same time shall things come into thy mind. He's speaking about Gog, which represents Russia today. And thou shalt think an evil thought. So like I said, Russia right now, they're flexing their muscle, man. They're coming after the Ukraine, which rightly so, the Ukraine belongs to Russia. It was once part of Russia. So that's really not a big deal. And the clip that Mwatizak played, this guy was talking about Vladimir Putin, how he said he's reserving his best soldiers to really come against America. He's not sending his best soldiers to the Ukraine, you know, because that's a small thing to him. He said he's reserving his best soldiers for America. So that's in the mind of Vladimir Putin to eventually come against America. And this is Bible prophecy. This is what we're reading here. Ezekiel 38. And I believe that Vladimir Putin is the guy, man. He got to be that dude, man. He got to be. He has all the charm. All right? He has all the charm for this prophecy. Ezekiel 38. And let's read the 10th verse again. Thus saith the Lord power, it shall also come to pass that at that same time shall things come into thy mind, and thou shalt think an evil thought. And thou shalt say, I will go up to the land of unwalled villages. What land is that? America. Unwalled villages. Okay? Back in the past, cities had a wall around them. Case in point, Jericho. Now, you come over here to America, the cities don't have a wall around them. Okay, you can drive from one city into another city. All you have to do is pass basically the sign. You know, like when we leave New York, when we're coming back to Connecticut, there's a sign that says, welcome to Connecticut. Okay, so once you pass that, guess what? You have left from New York into Connecticut. There's no wall there. Okay, so this is what is meant by the land of unwalled villages. It's talking about America. I will go to them that are at rest. Again, you know that's talking. America's fun land. Okay, the order of the day for the average so-called American is fun, fun, fun. They even had a song like that by the Beach Boys. It either was Jan and Dean or the Beach Boys. I think it was the Beach Boys. You know, and part of the song went, she'll have fun, fun, fun until her daddy takes the T-Bird away. Remembering the lyrics of the song, but that gives you an idea of what America is. America is all about that fun. It's the, this is the land of mirth. Matter of fact, New York is also known as Gotham City. Gotham means fool. Look up the word, it means fool. Okay, so this is the land of foolishness, the land of mirth, the land of joy, you know. So, of course the people are at rest. So here's the Russians, and you know the Russians, they're built for war, man. Okay, that's just the spirit the Lord got on them. So here, led by Vladimir Putin, here he's saying, I will go to them that are at rest. That's your average so-called American. That dwell safely, all of them dwelling without walls and having neither bars nor gates. I already explained that. To take a spoil and to take a prey. So see, it is in the mind of Vladimir Putin eventually to invade this place. And then you know what? All the other nations, they're seeing that America is becoming weak and weak and weak. There's a scripture where it says, art thou become as weak as we? There was one time where America was the big boss. You know, go back to during the time of Hiroshima and Nagasaki. All right, when it was the Americans that dropped the atomic bomb. And all the other nations were afraid, man. They saw that power and they backed up. They said, whoa. You know, but now, guess what? The other nations have nuclear warfare. Not only do they have atomic warfare, they have nuclear warfare as well. They got the bomb too. So, you know, their attitude is, look, we're just as powerful as you. And we're not afraid to use these missiles, you know, on you. You know, this is their attitude towards America. So America's not the big bully on the block like it used to be. All right, so again, eventually Russia is going to attack this place, man. It's inevitable. It's Bible prophecy, and I'm reading it. Ezekiel 38 and 12, to take a spoil and to take a prey and to turn thine hand upon the desolate places that are now inhabited and upon the people that are gathered out of the nations. Yeah, one of the terms for America is the melting pot. You have all kind of different nations gathering here. So you know this is talking about America. Just because you don't see the word America doesn't mean it's not talking about America. Which have gotten cattle and goods that dwell in the midst of the land. America is known for its great riches. Okay? Matter of fact, let's bring in this article that I have here. This is from Insider, dated March 17th, 2022. Let's read the title here. I'm sorry. Here it is right here. Here's the title. It says, the UN said nuclear war is back within the realm of possibility. See? Here are the places in the US most likely to be hit in a nuclear attack. And guess who's going to lead that nuclear attack? Russia. Why? Because it's part of Bible prophecy. The Lord said, I'm going to be sanctified in thee, O Gog, when I make you go up against America, against Babylon the Great, to destroy it. And not just you, other nations will be joining you. Okay? And this is what I just read here, Ezekiel, the 38th chapter, beginning at the 10th verse. Okay? So it's inevitable, man. It is inevitable. And like I said, this article backs it up, this article here, which I will put in the description box. Again, the UN said nuclear war is back within the realm of possibility. Here are the places in the US most likely to be hit in a nuclear attack. So nuclear war is not out the picture, man. Let's listen some more of Mawatazak.
We're at the end. Not only do we have this World War III that's getting ready to jump off, mm-hmm. with the invasion of America, you have the Ukraine war, you go on there, you have the Middle East, they've been at war, you know, it's just been war. But now, the virgin daughter of Babylon, all right, which is the U.S., all right, America, they're getting ready to have their cherry popped when it comes to outside nations occupying and attacking and invading this land, okay?
Yeah, real talk, man. Real talk. Again, Ezekiel, the 38th chapter, clearly goes into it, clearly lays it out. Another scripture that comes to mind is Jeremiah, the 50th chapter. Another scripture that speaks about nuclear war. Actually, Jeremiah, the 51st chapter. Jeremiah 51 and 1. Thus saith the Lord, behold, I will raise up against Babylon. This Babylon is talking about is America. And against them that dwell in the midst of them that rise up against me, a destroying wind. Because ancient Babylon was not destroyed in that manner by a destroying wind. The destroying wind is talking about is when those missiles explode and they create that wall of fire. One scripture that comes to mind is where the Lord said, I will sweep it with the besom of destruction. You look up the word besom, it means a sweeping agent. Now, a good movie to show you a visual of that is the movie Terminator 2, if you have not seen it. The scene with the woman who played Sarah Connor, and she's resting on that fence. She's in a dream, and she sees herself playing with some children. And all of a sudden, this giant flash happens. And then you see a wall of fire. It looked like a broom. A wall of fire sweeping across the land, destroying everything in its path. So that's that destroying wind that the Lord is talking about here. Okay, the destroying wind. And again, Russia and the other nations that's going to be with Russia is going to lead the charge. Okay? And will send unto Babylon fanners that shall fan her. Even now, America's on the brink of destruction. You got all kind of problems. Those are that's like the fanners that is fanning the flames of destruction here. The different problems that America has. The gas crisis, once again. America's had that before, but once again, we're in a gas crisis, and it doesn't look like it's gonna stop anytime soon. It's only gonna get worse. What else? You got the GMO foods. That's a crisis, even though it's not really in the news like it should be. You got these different plandemics, shall I say, pestilences. Now we're dealing with the MP. You know, I don't want to say, you know, the monkey, you know what. So all of this is designed to eventually bring America to its knees. You know, you got race wars. You know, you got shootings as of late. Mass shootings have been plaguing the news. Mass shootings, right? So all of these are fanners that eventually will empty this land, will bring it to the brink of destruction. And will send unto Babylon fanners that shall fan her and shall empty her land. See? Bring it to the brink of destruction. For in the day of trouble, they shall be against her round about. And eventually, America will be invaded. Will be invaded by Russia and the other nations. Namely, China. I believe Libya is going to be in there. Iran. Okay, these are countries that hate America, man. All right, so this place will be invaded. There's no doubt about it. All right. Before Yahushua comes and destroys this society, America will be invaded by outside forces. Like Mwatazak said, America's going to get her cherry popped. All right. Against him that bendeth, let the archer bend his bow, which is a metaphor for those missiles. And against him that lifteth himself up in his brigandine, and spare not her young men, destroy ye utterly all her host. See? So that's the spirit that the Lord is going to put on the so-called Russians, man. Let me bring in another scripture. The Kings. I think it's somewhere in (clears throat) roughly paraphrasing it, it says, the Lord have raised up the spirit of the kings of the Medes. Let me try one more time. Here it is right here. Jeremiah 51:11. So I was already in the chapter. Just had to go a few verses down. Jeremiah 51:11, make bright the arrows, gather the shields. Again, that's a metaphor for those missiles. The Lord have raised up the spirit of the kings of the Medes. That's Russia today. Okay, that is Russia today. Okay, because the land where Russia is located was once controlled by the Medes. Okay. Going back to the seed of Japheth, the spirit of the kings of the Medes, for his device is against Babylon to destroy it. Now remember earlier, we read where the Lord said he has a sacrifice in Bozrah. All right, so we explained that. Bozrah, the modern day Bozrah is America. So here, the Lord's device is to do what? Against Babylon to destroy it. This Babylon is talking about is America. Okay? So again, Russia will invade this place. It's inevitable. For his device is against Babylon to destroy it, because it is the vengeance of the Lord, the vengeance of his temple. See? Then it goes on to say, set up the standard upon the walls of Babylon, make the watch strong. That's exactly what we're doing. We're making the watch strong because we keep talking about it. We keep prophesying again, about it. Okay? We're making the watch strong. We're informing you brothers and your sisters out there that watch these videos of what's to come concerning America and Russia. Make the watch strong, okay? Set up the watchmen. Set up the watchmen. Who are the watchmen? Well, that's the Lord's prophets, his apostles, his teachers, right? We're the watchmen. It says, set up the watchmen. Prepare the ambushes, for the Lord have both devised and done that which he spake against the inhabitants of Babylon. See? So it must happen, man. America must go to war with Russia. And then in that case, America is going to be destroyed. Okay? Going to be laid on heaps. Let's get back to the video.
It's land, okay? Now, without any further ado, because I wrote down a few scriptures that I want to hit concerning this information that I got off of Britian Health Ranger page, which is Mike Adams off of the Natural News website, okay? Which he usually comes with some pretty good information that we could filter through the scriptures. And, you know, his sources that he's tied to are you know, pretty accurate as far as these world events that pop off, okay? But we know them as biblical prophecies, okay? You don't hear them say these things when they're breaking these things down. They're saying it as America's going to be occupied and we're going to be at war for years. This is not what's going to take place. What's going to take place is When everything jumps off, it's gonna start to move fast. Everything's gonna move. Everything is gonna hit all at once. All right, you're gonna have CHIP being administered. Okay, you're gonna have a whole lot going on, man. And then you're gonna have to worry about these troops that's getting ready to invade out here, man. Especially. Here on the West Coast, and north as we're getting ready to read, all right? Because the scriptures speak about they're going to come from the north. And this is the information I was listening to him, listening to his podcast he uploaded on the 7th, all right? Now, his sources is, which he interviewed this man before, and they were breaking down the audio that was leaked. And, you know, you can listen to this whole thing. He brings out a lot of information of what's going on. The real reason China is locking their people down. They're basically turning their economy into a war zone economy. All right, like they at war, okay? And they're you know, doing all of these things under disguise, as well as Russia, all right?
Yeah, and speaking of China, again, that's the prophecy in the Apocrypha, in particular in the book of 2 Esdras, 16th chapter, where it speaks about war unto thee, Asia, thou art partaker of the hope of Babylon. That's what that means. You know, the so-called Chinese, they think they're the next to rule, okay? And they're going to help the so-called Russians come and attack this place. Okay, that's they're part of that army, that great army that's going to be brought upon this place.
Information that he's bringing out, that he says, which I'm only going to play a little bit because, you know, it's an hour and something long, hour and 8 minutes long. He said that the Russians don't even have their best soldiers in Ukraine. They're just taking it over with their, I guess, mediocre or second best soldiers. But their top notch soldiers are the ones that's getting ready to invade from the north. All right, they're gonna come from the north, like the scriptures say. All right. And they're going to invade this place, okay? They're going to think that evil thought and come to the unwalled villages, all right?
And I just read that prophecy. That's Ezekiel, the 38th chapter, beginning at the 10th verse.
Now, again, I'm going to play this a little bit, and we're going to go right to the scriptures, all right? Because time is short, man. You know, every day that goes by, all right, we're that much more closer to total hell, chaos, and destruction breaking loose in the streets of America. Okay, we are that close. People are already losing their minds, and a lot of these people that's losing their minds are those that's been lingering with that potion up in them. Okay, women just killing their kids and calling the police on themselves. All type of stuff is happening, you know. But let me stick to the topic. Sometimes I just, you know, be going off topic, but that's all right. So let's play this here. Listen up. Make sure the volume's up.
Sentence into this, let me continue. Quote, however, he says, this is Mr. Wong says, Russia's best forces are not being used in Ukraine. They've been deployed in the Far East, prepared for action against America. This is another bombshell. It means that Russia's best troops have not been deployed in Ukraine. They're getting ready to invade America from the north, by the way. From the north, yeah. Alaska and...
From the north, by the way.
And that lines up right with, right along with Bible prophecy. All right? So at this point, I'll leave it there. Hopefully you were edified. Please leave your comments leave your scriptures in the comment section below. Again, hopefully you were edified by this video. So on to the next one.